kayak?
Yes, free boats. Yeah. All right, folks, we're here today to share the word of God. And we're going to look at Ephesians chapter 1. Well, we go with Ephesians chapter 4, and it says, Ephesians 4, to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption as sons. So God has sought to redeem us. And what that means is he paid a price for us, and that price, it was the price of his Son, the Son of God, who knew no sin, the Son of God, who knows no lie, the Son of God. Son of God, who is perfect, the Son of God, who is pure. And as the Son of God, he was the perfect sacrifice that was made for you and me. Now you and I have to realize our awful condition. You and I have to realize the problem that we're in, that God is a holy God. It says in the Bible, holy, 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 Lord God was and is to come, he's a holy God. And as a holy God, he cannot look upon sin. He cannot look upon that which is unholy. And so God is a holy God. It says in the Bible, holy, 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 Lord God, who was and is to come, is a holy God. And as a holy God, he demands perfection, he demands purity. And if you want to know God, if you want to be in a relationship with God, if you want to know God and be in a relationship with God, then you've got to understand how to get in relationship with God. That there is a God to seek after, there is a God to pursue, there is a God to love, there is a God to adore, and this God is worth pursuing, this God is worth adoring, this God is worth living for he is holy and pure and glorious, he's a majestic God. And the question of all questions is, do you want to know this God? Do you want a relationship with this God? Do you want to be in relationship with this God? Amen. God bless you, bro. Do you want to be in a relationship with this God? Do you want to know this God? Do you want to know the living God and be in relationship with God? Do you want to know God? Do you want to know God? Do you want to be in fellowship with God? Do you want to love God, adore God, praise God, worship God? Does God want to, do you want God to be at the center of your life? To love God, to adore God, to praise Him, to bring glory to Him, to bring honor to Him, to pursue Him, pursue Him, pursue God, to love God, to adore God, to live for God, to pursue Him with all our hearts, and to love Him with all our hearts, and to bring glory to Him, live for Him, adore Him, magnify Him. For God is on His throne, and God is King, and God is over all, and God is mighty, and God requires of you what you will do with Him. Whether you will worship Him, or whether you worship yourself. Whether He is number one, or you're number one. Whether you live for Him, or you live for yourself. God is worth pursuing, for God is the end of all things. God is to be glorified. God is to be magnified. God is King. God is sovereign. And God is all powerful. And there is no one who's greater than God. And you know He exists. You know this God exists. You know this God exists. And God requires that all of us repent. That all of us repent. Repentance means that we turn away from that which is against God and we turn to God. We flee that which is evil and we turn to that which is the purest of all, pure, the everlasting God. We turn to him.
When we
turn to him, we find peace. As we turn to the gospel, as we turn to Christ, we will find peace. We will find forgiveness. We will find joy and hope. When we realize that he paid our redemption with his own blood, the riches of his grace, that he paid our redemption, that he came down from heaven, and then he was crushed on that cross. He was crushed on that cross. And the wrath of God came down upon the Son. And when he was on that cross, and there he hung on that cross, the punishment for you and I, the wrath of God fell upon him. The wrath of the Father fell upon him. And there he was judged for your sin. There every lie that you did, every immoral act that you did, the wrath of God was poured upon him. And he was crushed for you. He was crushed for you. He was crushed for you. Come on, have a debate. Come on, have a debate. Come on. Come on now. He was crushed for you. He was crushed for you on that cross. There he hung on that cross, and he was crushed for you. Shed his blood and take the wrath that you deserve. Took the judgment that you deserve, took the punishment that you deserve upon himself. But if you miss the blood of Christ, if you miss Jesus, then you fling yourself into the wires of hell, into the flames of hell. You throw yourself into the flames of hell if you miss Jesus. If you miss him, you miss life. You miss the Son of God. You miss eternal salvation.
If you miss
Christ, you miss it all, and you're lost forever and ever and ever and ever. You're lost in hell forever. Where there be weeping and gnashing of teeth. There ain't no sex in hell. There ain't no alcohol in hell. There ain't no drugs in hell. There ain't no Coronation Street in hell. It's one agony after another, weeping and gnashing of teeth in hell. You do not want to go there, for God is an awesome God, and his fire is fire, and it's a consuming fire, and you do not want to go to hell. But he was crushed for you. He was crushed for you. He was crushed for you. He was crushed on that cross. He was crushed on that cross and gave his life for you. And shed his blood on that cross. He was crushed. He was crushed for every sin that you and I did. He was crushed for every evil that you did. He was crushed. He was broken for you and me on that cross. There he hung on the cross, taking your punishment. How he loved. How he loved you. How he gave his life for you. How broken for you. The Son of God, who knew no evil. There he loved you. There he died for you. There he was broken for you. There he shed his blood. Oh, how he loved you. Oh, how he gave his life for you. God bless you, bro. Oh, how he loved you. How he shed his blood for you. How he gave his life for you. How he died for you. How he gave his life. God bless you, bro. It's all right, right? Yeah. How he loved you. How he gave his life. How he gave his life. Christ.
Crushed for you.
Crushed for me. Crushed on the cross. Taking the wrath of the Father upon himself. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. Isaiah 53. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. The Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. And every evil act that I did, every wicked thing that I ever did, every wicked thing that you were prepared. There, he hung on that cross, and there he took my wrath, he took your wrath, he died in your place. He died in your place. He died in my place. Every time you get blooded on a Saturday night, you put it to the cross. Every time you sleep to ride, you put it to the cross. Every time you lie to your girlfriend and your boyfriend, you put it to the cross. For God, he hung and died for you. He was bruised for all iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. The Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Can't you see his love for you? Can't you see him pleading for you? Can't you see it's time to believe? It's time to trust. It's time to repent. Now is the day of salvation. Now is the day of salvation. Now is the time. Now is the time. Now is the time to be washed. Now is the time to be forgiven. Now is the time. You might not get a chance again. End up in hell next week. Now is the time. Now is the time. Off the walkie-talkie, no dealing in walkie-talkie. Put your faith in Jesus. Now is the time. Now is the time to trust him. Now is the time to believe in him. Now while you have the chance, now while you can repent, now you can forgive him now. Now is the day before the wrath of God comes and crushes us, and crushes you into the flames of judgment. Now is the day that you need to repent and turn away from that which is wrong. Now is the day to believe. Now is the day to trust him. Now is the day to believe. To believe him now is the time to trust him now. While you can now. Know his love now, know his joy now, know his peace now, know his forgiveness now, know his cleansing now, know his washing now, know his mercy now, know his love now, know his forgiveness now, know his now. That you can be forgiven today, right now. Right now you can be forgiven. Forgiven of all your sin, forgiven of all you've done wrong, forgiven in every way you can be forgiven. Washed in the blood of the Lamb. Washed in the blood of the Lamb. Washed in the blood of the Lamb. You can have it right now. If only you would believe. Still God saying, I don't believe, Jay. You believe, you know there is a God. You know what is right and wrong. And you're headed for hell. You're headed for judgment. You're headed for the wrath of God. You're headed for hell, my friend. You're headed for hell. You're heading for hell. You're heading there if you don't trust him. You're heading for hell if you keep doing what you're doing. Don't do it. He comes right now in his love and says, come on. Come on, I died for you. Wake up. Wake up, I died. I give my life for you. Take what you're doing. Give my life for you. I'm the one that died for you. I am the one that rescued you. I am the one that loved you. I am the one that loved you. For you. But before it's too late, before you jump into hell, you might die tomorrow. You might die next week. God bless you, yeah. Okay. Oh, okay. Amen. Amen. You're the star, mate. God bless you. Come out with us. Yeah. Yeah. Alright, God bless you. Alright, mate, God bless you, bro. He dies! And he doesn't want you to go to the flames of hell, but there is a judgment. He took the judgment for you. He took the punishment for you. He died in your place. 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 There's no other way. There's no other way to heaven. There's no other way to salvation. There's no other way to be forgiven. There's no other way. The only way to be saved. The only way to be born again. The only way to be saved, to get right with God. The only way is Christ.
But he is perfect.
He was holy. He was pure. And he went to that cross and was whipped and mocked and humiliated.
And he went to that cross.
That is the only way to be saved, by his blood. The blood of Christ redeems you. The blood of Christ redeems you. The blood of Christ sets you free. The blood of Christ pays your debt. The blood of Christ cleanses you. The blood of Christ saves you. For the blood was shed, and only by the blood can you be saved. For the blood was holy blood. The blood was the blood of God, and the blood was given on Calvary 2,000 years ago, and that blood was given for you, my friend. And if you come and cry out for forgiveness, you will be forgiven. You will be forgiven and set free. You'll be forgiven and set free today. But you've got to cry out. You've got to cry out and you'll be set free. You'll be forgiven
if you cry out and ask for forgiveness in him.
For he loved you and gave his life for you. Shed his blood for you. And died in your place. And you can be redeemed today. You can be redeemed today by the blood of the Lamb. Behold. Behold him. You see, it's him. Look at him. Look at him dying on that cross. Look at him dying there for you and for me. He died there for you and for me. And that is the answer to your questions. That is the answer to your problems. That is the answer to why you're here and where you're going is on the cross. That is the answer for you. That is your answer, the cross. There you know where you're going. There you know what you're doing when you realize that he died on that cross. God bless you. When you realize he died on that cross to pay your debt, then you know who you are. You know that you're forgiven. You know that you've been restored. You know that all you should have been and will be and ever will be is because he died on that cross for you. The way home is the cross. Paul said, we preach Christ crucified. We preach Christ crucified. Christ was crucified on the cross for you. He shed his blood on the cross for you. And that is salvation. That is what you're missing. You're missing that. You're missing it, my friend. You're missing it. What you're going for is dung. What you're going for is pig food. You're going for pig food. When you've got spiritual food that you can go for, heavenly food in Christ, and you're missing it, my friend. You're missing all the blessings that you have in God. You're missing it, my friend. You're missing all that God has for you. You're missing everything that God has for you. You're rejecting all that God has for you. You're missing the blessing. You're missing all that is there for you if only you would believe and trust in him. You're missing it, my friend. You're missing all the blessings. You're missing all the blessings. All the blessings that you can have are in Christ. All the blessings. All the blessings are in Christ. All the blessings are in him. You're missing all those blessings. All those wonderful blessings of heaven. All the wonderful blessings of knowing God. All the blessings you're missing. All the blessings of God. All the riches of God. You're missing it. Don't put your faith in Jesus Christ. You're missing it all, my friend. You're missing it all. You're throwing away your heritage. You're throwing away heavenly blessings. You're throwing away heavenly blessings, eternal blessings. You're throwing it all away if you don't believe in Jesus. If you don't believe in Jesus, you're throwing your life away. You're throwing your soul away. You're throwing it away for dung, for pig food. You're throwing your heritage away and all that Christ has for you. All the blessings for you. All the eternal blessings are there in Christ. The riches of His grace. But no, I want to get drunk on a Saturday night. I want to get drunk. And you're throwing all that God has given you. All the grace. You're throwing it away and going to hell. I want to watch porn. I want to take drugs. Sex outside of marriage. And you're throwing it all away. You're throwing it away. You're throwing the blessings away. And you're throwing yourself into hell. And you're missing the beautiful in Christ. The joy, the peace, the love of God. And all the wonderful blessings in Christ. Your salvation and your inheritance. You're throwing it away. And you're throwing it away for nothing. So what you have sex? So what you have drugs? So what you win the lottery? If you win the lottery, you're still going to hell if you don't believe in Jesus. If you have sex outside of marriage, you're still going to hell if you don't have Jesus. If you're the richest man in the world, you're still going to hell if you don't have Jesus. If you're famous, you're still going to hell if you don't have Jesus. If you're politically correct, you're still going to hell if you don't have Jesus. You're missing it all if you don't trust Him. He's the riches of His grace. The riches of His grace and in Christ and all. That is for you. If I give you £1 million and say, here's £1 million, would you take it? God is giving you more than He's giving Himself. He's giving to you. The riches of His grace.
You. It's there for you.
If only you would repent. If only you would confess your sin. If only you would be honest with yourself. And you know what? You say, you know what? I lied today and I shouldn't have lied. You know what? I lied to my boyfriend. You know what? I lied to my girlfriend. You know what? I lied to my mama and I lied to my papa. And you be honest with yourself that you've lied and you shouldn't have lied. And you repent and you say, Lord, forgive me for my lies. I'm sorry for my lies. And we be honest with ourselves that we've broken the Lord of God, the commandments of God. We've broken them and we need forgiveness. And all there is forgiveness. Oh, you can be a prostitute all your life and be forgiven right now and know peace and love. You can be a drug dealer all your life, but if you believe in Jesus, you can be forgiven right now. Right now, you can have a new start. Right now, you can be forgiven. Right now, you can have a new life. Right now. Right now, you can have a new start, a new life, a new purpose. You can have new joy, new peace, new hope, new life right now with Him. If only you believe in Him and trust in Him. Clothed with Him. Clothed with Christ. Clothed with Christ. Pursue Christ. Desire Christ. Love Christ. Trust Christ. Honor Christ. Follow Christ. For me to live is Christ, to die is gain. Live for Christ. Die for Christ. Put Christ first in your life. Put Him first in your life. Make Him number one in your life. Make Him number one. Please make Him number one. The rich love is there for you. He loves you and He wants the blessings for you. They're there for you. They're all there for you. They're all there for you. But you've got to take it. You've got to repent and rest in Christ and only Christ. Only He can be the rock and foundation. Only He can be the one that we stand on. And that is Christ, my friend. He is the only one that we can stand on. We can't stand on drugs. drugs will pull us down. You can't stand on gang warfare. Some of you are joining gangs. Your gang is not your answer to your problem. The gangs are not your answer, mister. Joining a gang is not your answer. It's not going to help you with joining a gang. Carrying a knife and carrying a gun ain't going to help you. What you need is come to Jesus. That's what you need. What you need is Jesus, not a gun, not a knife, but Jesus. That's what you need. That's what you need. You ain't hard carrying a gun. Who do you think you are carrying a gun? You ain't hard carrying a gun. You ain't hard carrying a knife. Mr. Drug Dealer, Mr. Gang Warfare Guy with your gun. You're not tough, you're not hard carrying a gun. Joining a gang but terrorizing the local community with a gun. You're not tough, you're not hard. You're not tough carrying a gun. Repent. Pull that gun and take it to the police station. Take your knife and take it to the police station. Put down your knife, put down your gun, put down your drug dealing, and repent of your gun, repent of your knife, repent of your drug dealing, repent of your sex trafficking, repent of it and turn away from it. And know that Christ has died for you, Mr. Drug Dealer. Stop being a preacher. Gang warfare member, your little gun. A preacher, Mr. Gang Warfare member. Put your gun down, Mr. Gang Warfare man. Deep in your heart, riding your BMW and dealing in your drugs. You ain't tough. You need to repent, Mr. Drug Dealer. Stop being a preacher, Mr. Drug Dealer. Stop preaching the Bible, Mr. Drug Dealer. Hey, pimp. You're pimping those girls, are you? You need to repent of your pimping, Mr. Pimp. And you need to stop it, Mr. Pimp. For he says, do not commit adultery, Mr. Pimp. You need to repent of your pimping, Mr. Pimp. Stop your pimping. And stop being a preacher, Mr. Pimp. Start lifting Christ up in your life. Start lifting him up. Start proclaiming him. Preaching him. Proclaiming him. Lifting him. Start magnifying him in your life. Magnify him in your life. Magnify him in your family. Magnify him. Lift him up. Lift Christ up. Bring glory to Christ and honor Christ and lift Christ. For me to live is Christ, to die is gain. Lift Christ up in your life. Lift Christ up. No more drug dealing. No more gang warfare. No more carrying guns, no more carrying knives. Put your knives down and your guns down. Start lifting Christ up. Start lifting Christ up. Magnify Christ in your life. Magnify Christ in your life. Magnify Christ in your life. Lift Christ in your life. And swear it. Some of you swear like a gangster rapper. Some of you need to wash your mouth out with soap. Some of you are swearing on the bus, you're swearing on the tram, and you're swearing. And he says, do not use the Lord's name in vain, and you're using the name of the Lord as a swear word. Wash your filthy mouth out. Wash it out with soap. And no swearing like a gangster rapper. Remember, that he wants you to have a clean mouth that says nice things to people, not swear words. Nice things to people, not swear words, yeah? No swearing in the nightclubs, no swearing in the pubs, no swearing. For he says, do not use the Lord's name in vain. Ten Commandments, 101, bros. Ten Commandments, 101, no swearing. No swearing in the pubs, no swearing in the nightclubs, no swearing in the family, no swearing on the streets, no swearing, no swearing. Don't use the Lord's name in vain, no swearing. Stop the swearing, repent of the swearing. Let's have clean mouths, with saying nice things to people and not swearing and being nasty to people. Thou shalt not. Thou shalt. Sorry. Not use the Lord's name in vain. So have you been swearing today? Have you been swearing this week? God bless you. Have you been swearing this week? No swearing. It's not a Jeremy Kyle show. Where you think you can effing Jeff? No effing a Jeff in Manchester anymore. It's banned. No swearing. Okay? No swearing in Manchester. It's banned. It says in the Ten Commandments, thou shalt not use the Lord's name.